On a scale of 1 to 10, would you recommend this video to a friend? Have you ever seen that phrase before? That phrase is an example of a question used to determine a customer relationship metric, known as NPS, Net Promoter Score. Net Promoter Score measures the difference between the number of people who would recommend or promote something, be it a brand, product, service, or interface, and the number of people who would actively detract or criticize that thing. Anyone who scores between a 9 and a 10 is considered a promoter. Anyone who scores 7 or 8 would be considered passive, as in unlikely to promote or criticize. And anyone who scores 6 and below would be considered a detractor. Using the responses to this survey, you would calculate NPS with the following formula: the number of promoters who voted 9 and over, times 100, divided by the total number of respondents, all minus the number of detractors who voted 6 and below, times 100, divided by the total number of respondents. This may seem pretty harsh of a scoring system. So what is the reasoning behind NPS? And why exclude the passives from the numerator? Well, the idea is this. People put their reputations on the line when they recommend something. It's not only the product or the service or the brand in question, but also the taste and the judgment of the recommender. Similarly, a detractor may be upset enough about an experience that they're willing to put their own reputations up for scrutiny with negative feedback. Passives, on the other hand, are unlikely to say anything at all, therefore not impacting that net attitude toward the brand or offering. So, this metric can tell us a lot about perceived brand loyalty, or lack thereof, and social sentiment of a brand or offering. NPS can be really useful for a number of reasons. It's well known and liked by upper management, so you won't have to make a case for it usually. It's also relatively easy to collect data. It's a single question survey, so you're likely to get a good response rate. It's also correlated with other metrics like company growth rate, user satisfaction ratings, and sometimes even system usability scale ratings. But it is not a perfect metric. First of all, self-reporting is unreliable, and sometimes people will say something, maybe say they would recommend when they wouldn't, and in reality, maybe not recommend or behave differently. And because it's a quantitative metric, you need a large sample. I'm talking hundreds, maybe thousands of responses. So it's not necessarily better. And it's not necessarily better than satisfaction ratings. Remember, correlation does not mean causation. NPS doesn't explicitly measure usability, and if not used in concert with other metrics, it can vastly oversimplify the data. All that said, it does not mean that you shouldn't use NPS. NPS is a great way to add quantifiable value to something historically seen as fluffy. But as with any other quantitative metric, supplement it with qualitative data to not only tell you what is happening, but why it's happening in the first place. UX is a nuanced, contextual field which will never be captured or defined by a single number or performance metric. But with our careful research and analysis, these metrics can tell us a lot about how we are doing and how we can better meet the needs of our customers.